Thailand has fascinating temples with marvelous architecture, intricate detail, and spectacular color. We visit the top three in the heart of Bangkok. A number of years ago, my wife and I traveled to Thailand, and visiting its temples was on the top of my wish list. The number one temple complex we see is Wat Prakeo on the King's Palace grounds, with its prominent emerald Buddha. Next, we visit the neighboring Wat Po complex with the massive reclining gold Buddha. And towering high on the west bank of the river is Wat Arun, one of Thailand's most iconic structures. Bangkok wasn't always the capital of Thailand. The first major kingdom of Siam had a large capital city called Ayutthaya, and around 1700 AD, it had a population of about 1 million, making it one of the world's largest cities at the time. In 1766, the Burmese from present-day Myanmar attacked Ayutthaya, and after a 14-month siege, it was overrun and burned. While Siam made a rapid recovery, eventually regaining their independence, took the Chiang Mai region in the north, and established Bangkok as their new capital in 1782. And Thailand is also the only country in Southeast Asia not to be colonized by a Western power. Our first stop is at Bangkok's most visited temple, and also Thailand's most important. When Bangkok was declared the new capital of Thailand in 1782, King Rama I built his grand palace. And for 150 years, the palace was the home of the Thai king, his royal court, and government. Although we didn't tour the palace buildings themselves, we were in awe with Wat Prakeo, a complex with a number of beautiful buildings built by successive kings. It's a grand display of architecture with intricate detail, showcasing the creativity and craftsmanship of the Thai people. King Rama IV built this gold chedi in Sri Lankan cone-shaped style, similar to ones in Ayutthaya. The Temple of the Emerald Buddha is the oldest and most important building on the grounds, built in 1783 by King Rama I. Inside resides the Emerald Buddha, considered the sacred Buddha image in the Thai kingdom. It was thought to have been created in Sri Lanka, spent time in Chiang Mai, and then brought here when the temple was built. The Buddha has three golden costumes which are changed with the seasons by the king or one of his children. Unfortunately, photography wasn't allowed inside. King Rama I also built two chedis like this one to commemorate his parents. Each is covered in gold leaf with a marble octagonal base and 16 giant monkeys supporting it. Here is a prayer hall called Wilhan Yat. It's unique, made with Chinese porcelain decorations, believed to be built by King Rama II. This dazzling building with the tall pillars on the right was also built by King Rama I, and it's a repository for sacred Buddha texts. The detail is fabulous. On the walls surrounding the temple grounds are these murals, over 1 kilometer long. Made in 178 panels, they tell the story of Rama's journey and depict ideal human relationships, the ideal father, wife, brother, and servant. We make our way over to Wat Po, Bangkok's largest and oldest temple complex. It was originally built in the 16th century, but largely reconstructed by Rama I in 1788. It's famous for its giant reclining Buddha, 46 meters long, covered in gold leaf. A reclining Buddha symbolizes his arrival at Nirvana. The soles of his feet have 108 images designed with mother of pearl. And here are 108 bronze bowls to match the 108 images on his feet. There are about 100 chedis on the grounds, all decorated in beautiful porcelain mosaic. Our last visit in Bangkok is across the river to Wat Arun, one of Thailand's most popular landmarks. It's also known as the Temple of Dawn. With an impressive height of 81 meters, the first light of the morning sun reflects off its ceramic surface, creating a pearly shine of changing color. It was the first temple constructed in honor of Thailand's new capital after the fall of Ayutthaya. Its architecture is more of a Khmer style, like we saw in Cambodia's Angkor Park. Its tall central tower was completed in 1824. Thank you. If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified of new releases. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.